So I think my only complaint, I guess, is the word about the HL15 is how loud the fans are in the device. I know that they're high static pressure fans. They're meant to move a lot of air, but that does often come at the cost of noise.
What is that? Why is it making that noise?
It was at this point he knew something was f***ed up.
That beep didn't sound good. So I hopped onto my computer and logged into the IPMI interface / dashboard thing and looked at the sensors page to see if it was maybe overheating. And 90 degrees Celsius isn't good. And even though this was the first time hearing these beeps, it turned out that the CPU had been throttling off and on for days.
So for a couple of days this week, it was pretty hot here in Colorado. So I went ahead and just put this fan pumping more air directly in there. It brought it down quite a bit as far as temperatures are concerned, but obviously that's not ideal. It's not on right now, so the fan noise you're hearing is actually from the HL15, and having this, again, not ideal. So I think at this point it's time to dig in to a care pack that Noctua sent and get the cooling in the HL15 rectified. So this is the care pack that Noctua was so awesome to send me. I actually reached out to them before I got the HL15, like I knew it was on its way, but asked if they could hook me up with a new cooling solution. Mostly I was interested in the fans because I'm 100% sure that these will be quieter than what's in there presently. But they also hooked me up with a tower cooler, some spacers, a hub, and a controller. And so this is all going to go in the HL15 today. Luckily for anybody moving forward, I believe, who's getting an HL15, they're already getting Noctua parts because of a recent partnership that they have with 45 Drives and the HL15 team. So let's go ahead and get some of this stuff unboxed and ready to put in my HL15.
So there were like 12 boxes and even more parts and a lot more accessories to get into and sorted into some different piles for easier migration into the HL15 case. I was honestly surprised at how many different mounting accessories came with the fans, and it really seems that Noctua has got you covered for all sorts of installation scenarios. With that out of the way, we can shut down my Proxmox server, pull the HL15 out of the rack, and start tearing into everything. So now I'm just pulling out the 10GB NIC and the RTX 2070 GPU that I had in there, and then disconnecting all of the wires. I made sure to take additional pictures of stuff I thought I might screw up later when putting things back together. Once I've got that done, I just need to remove about a dozen or so screws and lift the board out of the case. So at this point, I thought it was really, really important to make sure that I didn't center the shop properly, because honestly, who wants to see me remove a CPU from a motherboard?
Huh. Well, that wasn't supposed to come off like that. Or, well, maybe it actually was. Maybe it actually was. Wait, I'm so confused. Right. Oh, that's actually really good coverage.
So there was supposed to be some footage of reinstalling the cooler into the motherboard, but I must have accidentally bumped the mouse button and stopped the recording. But it was more or less the same process you couldn't see a moment ago, but in reverse. With the NHD9DX3647 4U CPU cooler installed, it was time to move on to getting the 6 fans and their spacers installed. Now, this was actually a pretty straightforward process because of the attention to detail that went into the HL15's design. After I got the first 3 fans installed behind the drives, I managed to, again, not record the installation of the 3 intake fans on the front. Do you guys understand the level of video creation professionalism you're witnessing here? I hope this is a humbling experience for each and every one of you, because it definitely was for me as I collected different bits of footage and realized some of the clips that I had missed. Now, it's just a matter of reassembling everything and cable managing a few things, and then getting the HL15 back into my server rack and then plugged into the power and network.
Okay, so this is a test run just to see what's gonna happen. Hopefully I can reach back here. Huh. Oh. Whoa. Okay. But it is moving a lot of air. And I can adjust it with this little knob. Oh, and the higher it is, the brighter that little orange light right there gets. So all the way down. And all the way up.
So at this point, I went over to my computer and logged into my IPMI dashboard so I could watch it boot up. Then I logged into Proxmox and noticed that there was something wrong.
Now it's not recognizing any of the
drives. Okay, so it turns out the reason that my storage pools weren't being recognized is because I had unplugged the power for the board underneath. Go me. So I got it all plugged back in and then realized I don't have enough ports on this power supply to power the hub and some other stuff that I need. So I'm gonna have to bypass this and this and just plug everything into. I've got plenty of fan headers on the board. Okay, so I've got 6 fan headers on this side, and I've got a CPU fan header up there, so everything is just gonna get plugged directly in. Also, it'll give me the opportunity to control the fans with the IPMI settings versus having to fiddle with this. So I'm gonna get all that swapped out and we'll come back and see what happens. So now that I'm getting all of this put back together, all of my drives are being recognized, all of my VMs and containers and everything are up and running, all of the fans are working, and you can't even hear them. Like, I'm right here and I just barely hear them. They're all running at like 400 RPMs. Everything here is working, everything's up and running. I'm really happy about all of this. And one of the things that really impresses me is how well thought out this chassis is. Like, they've made it so you can, you know, just pull out a couple of screws on either side and pull out this whole fan assembly. Actually, same thing here, sort of. Like, there's this bar that goes up in the front like this. Oops, come on. I was smarter. There we go. So this is just kind of an extra support brace, which I love. And I think it actually kind of maybe helps direct some of the air, maybe a little bit. But in order to get this bar out, there's a screw here. And of course, one on the other side as well. But it's actually hidden by this mounting bracket once you get it in place. And just some of the thought that went into how all of this should go together. And the stiff, like this is super thick steel here. Like, I don't say super thick, but it's like, it doesn't flex hardly at all. And it's a great feeling case. Gives you a sense of quality when you pick this thing up. It's heavy, it's like 40 pounds empty just because of all of the metal that they use here. And I just, as I was putting it back together, I was just kind of, I had to stop and appreciate how much thought went into this and the level of detail that they went through to get this thing put together the way they did. Okay, so here we are. Honestly, a few hours later than I wish it was. I ran into some issues that were totally my fault. It was a learning process for me, but I've got Bob's Burgers running in Plex over there. And if we take a look at my temperatures, they are now 75 degrees, sorry, 45 degrees. It used to be like 75 degrees at idle. And now even with a video playing through Plex, we're getting temperatures of like 45 degrees Celsius. If I just keep refreshing here, 44 degrees Celsius, 45, like all of these look really good. Of course, we've got the fan issues, but that's just because they have a tendency to run slower than the Super Micro board wants it to, based on its settings and whatnot. So I'm gonna call that a win, but there's even better news. Here we go. It's so quiet. So quiet compared to how it used to be. Like, it was actually causing me issues with being able to record in here without having to really tweak my audio in the end. And now I can barely hear it. And like I mentioned, temperatures of like 45 degrees there. Okay, so it's been a couple of days since I've got this done, and everything's been rock solid. My temperatures haven't gone over like 55, even under the most strenuous loads. So I'm super happy to have been able to work with Noctua to adjust the cooling capacity of this server. And also, I want to thank 45 Drives and the whole HL15 team for giving me the opportunity to check out their device. Again, they
Both of those companies recently partnered up so that they could provide you a better cooling solution up front. So you won't have to probably go through what I did over the last few days. But again, I'm super thankful that I had the opportunity to do that because it gave me the chance to get more familiar with the way the server's built, the quality of the parts, the server, the chassis, the motherboard, all of that. It felt really good to get my hands in there and actually have a chance to change some things out for myself and learn some new things. So yeah, great experience. There was some swearing, there was some frustration, but overall, really, really enjoyed doing it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching this video of me doing it. And I want to thank you guys for spending the last 10 or 12 minutes or however long this video is with me and kind of going along this journey with me. So I think with all that said, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up. I do want to thank you guys again for spending a few minutes of your day with me today. And I'll talk to you in the next video.